But before we do that, here are just two of the purple works of mercy, to feed the hungry and to give drink to the thirsty.
James chapter 2, verses 14 and 26 says, faith without work is dead. These works of mercy are the more practical and visible ways to exercise our faith to those in need.
Our feeding the poor on Saturdays is a great way to show what we preach.
I agree, but did you come any Saturdays? There are people with better cars than us, and some of them are drunk. I don't think they deserve it.
It's a great observation. We expect people to look deserving, but the reality is different. It's true that some people who come to feed the poor are drug abusers, alcoholics, or gamblers, but that's only a very small percentage. Regardless of who they are or what they are, if somebody is asking you for food, they are at a low point in their life.
Here are some quotes from famous people. There are people in the world so hungry that God cannot appear to them except in the form of bread. Mahatma Gandhi said that, and he's not even Christian. And Mother Teresa, if you can't feed 100 people, then feed just one. Feeding the hungry is no less than the worship of God.
Proverbs chapter 22, verses 8 to 9. The generous man is blessed, for he gives his bread to the poor.
Let us look at some facts about poverty in America. 15% of Americans live under poverty. Compare that to 22% of India.
76% of Americans live paycheck to paycheck. Only 38% of Americans have enough money to cover their needs.
Studies show an average American worker is 3 times at risk to support their family than an average Chinese worker.
1 in 5 of kids in the USA go to bed hungry with the hope of breakfast at school.
Even in Hillsborough County, there are about 2,000 homeless.
Thousands more live in the trailer parks like we have in our neighborhood. That is even worse than homelessness. These kids live a life we can't imagine, no heat or AC. Mega, can you imagine having to share your personal space with rats and snakes?
Not really, I'm not into that. We're so lucky though. Over 25% of Hillsborough County children go hungry every weekend.
Our feeding the poor is a great blessing to those around our church. You have to see it to believe it. Food pantries like ours provide some security for the families at high risk. We help families to stretch their paycheck to make ends meet.
We should be proud of what we do. We help families from falling into poverty, and we give a helping hand to the families in tough times.
A few weeks ago, when I was here, I saw a heart-wrenching story. That Saturday, it was raining heavy, and still about 60 people came for the food. And finally, we saw a young woman with her kids ages 2 to 5 on a bicycle trailer like this, completely wet. The kids just had warmer bags on them, and it melted my heart when I saw the little one come for food. He looked so happy.
I had a similar experience. There was a guy who came here asking for extra food. When I overheard a conversation with young folks, he said he tried for a job in Brandon, but things didn't work out. He doesn't have money for food or his family.
We can stand here and share similar stories like these.
But we're not going to. Our Feed the Poor is a no-cost way to show faith in action. Just 1 hour a week can make a big impact.
Your 1 hour can touch the lives of 100 people.
Your 1 hour can put a smile on a child's face.
Your 1 hour can make a child go to sleep without being hungry.
Your 1 hour can make angels jealous about you in heaven.
Do you remember our scramble from before? If you didn't know already, the answer is hungry.
Here is our tribute to all hardworking people behind the Feeding the Poor.
Sit down and enjoy.